How accurate is the second generation of Freestyle Libre flash monitoring system? In this video, I will share with you the results of a 4-week challenge that I went through. This consisted of 380 tests on Libre 1, Libre 2, and a glucometer. Coming up in this video. My name is Tom and I'm type 1 diabetic. Welcome, this is Type 1 Talks. On this channel, I cover various diabetes-related topics and share with you my diabetic journey. Currently, I'm working on a series of videos about the second generation of Freestyle Libre. So if you are new here, check out the other videos where I talk about Libre 2 new functionalities such as alarms. I will link the videos in the description below. By the way, I want to thank you so much for the first 100 subscribers. The fact that you are enjoying my videos and that you are joining Type 1 Talks community truly means a lot to me. Thank you. In the past 4 weeks, I went through a huge testing challenge using Libre 2, Libre 1 and finger pricking. More than 380 blood sugar tests to find out how accurate Libre 2 really is. How was the test done? I used two Libre 2 sensors, both placed on my upper arm as recommended by Abbott, and both, by the way, lasted full 14 days. Each day of the tests, I did at a minimum 4 readings using 3 different tools: Libre 2, Libre 1, and a glucometer, One Touch Vario Pro. Then I compared, analyzed, and assessed the results from all 3 sources. The testing was done in all kinds of real-life situations. I included low glucose situations, high glucose situations, and also the normal glucose situation. It was a real-life 4-week test. I also checked my blood sugar during various times of the day: before meal, after meal, daytime, and nighttime. All the sensors and testing strips used for this challenge were expiring no earlier than December 2019. In other words, none of them was expired at the time of the test. Before I get to the actual results, I need to cover a little bit of theory behind analyzing the results. If you're not a nerd and you only care if the Libre 2 did well, you can skip this part using timestamps. The theory will take 2-3 minutes. To assess the accuracy, I used mean absolute relative difference, or MARD, which is the most common method to assess the accuracy of continuous glucose monitoring systems such as Freestyle Libre or Dexcom. But what is MARD? Well, it is the average of the absolute error of sensor glucose reading compared to the blood glucose. In other words, when your blood glucose is 10 and your sensor glucose is 9, then the difference is 10%. The MARD will then be an average of these individual differences within the testing set. The lower MARD, the more accurate the testing device, so we want the MARD to be as low as possible. MARD up to 10 to 15% is normally considered sufficient to make a treatment decision. In other words, to make a decision if we should take additional insulin or if we should eat. By the way, if you want to receive the full results of my testing, wait till the end of this video and you will receive a spreadsheet with all the results. Before we look at the results, it is important to remember that Libre sensors or any other CGMs use the interstitial fluid to determine so-called sensor glucose. Glucometer, on the other hand, is using blood to determine blood glucose. These two methods provide slightly different results. I included a short video from Abbott which explains this really well.
Most of the time, glucose levels in the ISF and the whole blood are similar. However, when the glucose is changing rapidly, such as after meals, after insulin, or after exercise, the glucose level in the whole blood is not the same as glucose in the ISF. This difference in the rate of change is known as the lag.
You see, the expectation should not always be that sensor glucose and blood glucose will be exactly the same. I will play one more short piece that explains what the differences between blood glucose and sensor glucose are driven by.
Sensor glucose follows behind blood glucose. When the train is traveling along a flat plane, when there is little fluctuation in glucose levels, the blood glucose and sensor glucose readings will be very similar, although rarely exactly the same. Now think of going uphill on the train as a rise or upward trend in glucose levels. As the train starts up the hill, you can see that the blood glucose in the front car is leading the sensor glucose in the back car, because changes in glucose appear first in blood glucose. Now, as the train heads down the hill, or glucose is decreasing or trending down, once again, the blood glucose leads in the front car. So, as you can see, whether glucose levels are trending up or trending down, blood glucose leads sensor glucose.
There will always be bigger differences between blood glucose and sensor glucose on a bigger hills, in moments where glucose is changing rapidly, going up fast or going down fast. And now let's get to the results. So in total, I did over 380 blood sugar checks. I was able to make 130 comparisons between blood glucose from the glucometer and the sensor glucose from Libre 1 and Libre 2 readings. The average blood sugar from Freestyle Libre 1 was 5.1 millimol. The average blood sugar from Freestyle Libre 2 was 6.9 millimol, and the average blood sugar from glucometer was 7.5 millimol. That means that the average difference per one reading between Libre 2 and glucometer was 0.6 millimol, which is, I guess, acceptable. But for Libre 1, the average difference between sensor and glucometer was 2.5 millimol, which is very high. And I think the Libre 1 sensors that I used were faulty sensors. But now let's look at the most important indicator, MART. On Libre 2, I reached MART of 9.1%, which is within the desired 10% range. As you can see on the graph, I was able to achieve relatively consistent results throughout the whole 14-day period. MART was not lower than 16% on any single day, and I only had 3 days when the MART was higher than 10%. On the other hand, on Libre 1 sensor, my results were really bad. You can see the results in the range of 30%, 40%, and this is absolutely unacceptable. These sensors were clearly faulty sensors and I could not rely on them. To be a bit more fair with Libre 1, given the sensors I used were clearly faulty Libre 1 sensors, I compared my Libre 2 results to the results that Libre 1 achieved in the clinical trials. When I compared my Libre 2 results with the results of the clinical trials for Libre 1, Libre 2 seems to achieve a little bit better accuracy, and Libre 2 won this comparison on 11 out of 14 days. I also looked at MART levels in hypo situations and hyper situations. So in situations with the blood sugar below 3.9 millimol, the MART that I achieved with Libre 2 was incredible 4.7%, and in hyper situations with blood sugar above 9 millimol, the MART was 4.2%. This means that readings in both hypo and hyper situations were accurate enough for me to make treatment decisions based on them. I could rely on them in order to take more insulin or eat in order to bring the blood glucose up, which I think is a really great result. Overall, the sensor readings were typically a little bit lower than the glucometer results. However, not a big deal. I didn't have any extreme differences on any day out of these 4 weeks, and so I'm really happy with Libre 2 so far. Of course, these were just two sensors, and This may change as I receive different series that might become faulty, such as Libre 1 typically did. Some of the sensors were not good, but so far, so good. I will, of course, keep you up to date, and I will share more videos in case the accuracy of the results dramatically changes with a new series of Libre 2 sensors that I will be using. By the way, let me know if you are happy with the accuracy of results that you are getting from either Libre 1 or Libre 2 readings. Write in the comments below, are you happy, are you not happy, and can you rely on the sensor data, or do you have to check with the glucometer? I think that would make for a very interesting discussion, and I'm really curious to hear how you guys are happy with the readings, if you can rely on them. Let me know. If you managed to watch all the way here, thank you, and I have a bonus for you. In the description below, I will share with you the full results of all my 380 blood sugar checks. So, like this video and go to the description below where you can download the full testing spreadsheet and analyze it yourself if you want to see more of the details. Please don't forget, I make a new video every 2 weeks where I help you manage your diabetes and share my diabetic journey with you. If you want to see more of that, consider subscribing. As a disclaimer, please remember I'm not providing medical advice on this channel. I'm not a medical professional. I'm not affiliated with a company called Abbott, who is the manufacturer of Libre 1 and Libre 2 sensors. On this channel, I'm just sharing my diabetic journey for your fun and entertainment. And I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.